गुड आफ्टरनून टू एवरी वन. स्टे ट्यून विथ मॉडर्न ग्रुप्स ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशन. इट इज एन अप्रूव्ड इंस्टीट्यूट बाई AICT, PCI, NCT, न्यू डेली, एफिलेटेड टू RGPV भोपाल एंड DAVV इंदौर. अ बेस्ट रेनोवेड इंस्टीट्यूट फॉर फार्मेसी स्टडीज. आई एम मितेश सचदेवा, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन मॉडर्न इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल साइंसेज, अलवासा, इंदौर. Today I am going to discuss a new topic, resins, from the secondary metabolite part, which is the chapter second of unit 4 in fourth semester. Let us start with the definition, classification, properties and test for identification of resins. Here first we can discuss the introduction of resins. Resins are the amorphous products of complex chemical nature. They are transparent or translucent solids, semi-solids or liquid substances containing large number of carbon atoms. Basically, resins are the exudates of plants. That is, they are exudated out from the plant itself, which is an amorphous compound. And the nature of this exudate is complex. They are complex in their nature. They are high molecular weight hydrocarbons. These are the organic compounds having high molecular weight. They are transparent and translucent in their visual structures. They are either in the solid nature, semi-solid or liquid nature. They are hard, electrically non-conductive and combustible masses. They are usually formed in schizogenous or schizolysogenous cavities or ducts as the end products of metabolism. Actually, schizogenous or schizolysogenous cavities are the internal cavities of plants in which these resins are prepared. Most of the resins are heavier than water. They are insoluble in water but soluble in alcohol, volatile oils, fixed oils, colloidal hydrate and non-polar organic solvents like benzene and ether. So this is the solubility, where the resins are soluble or where they are insoluble in which different solvents. Now let us see the resins. The resins are produced by most plants is a viscous liquid. They are composed mainly of terpenes. Now what is the terpenes? Terpenes are mostly hydrocarbons. They are the building blocks and their structure consists of minimum 5 carbon isoprene units. The molecular formula is C5H8 of terpenes. These terpenes are highly aromatic compounds that determines the smell of many plants and herbs. So the resins consist of terpenes, and therefore the plants which consist of secondary metabolite resins have certain specific flavor or smell. They are with lesser components of dissolved non-volatile solids. They have less non-volatile solids, which make resin thick and sticky. Therefore, resin is very thick and sticky because they have less non-volatile solids. The individual components of resins can be separated by fractional distillation. The composition of resin varies with the species. The most common terpenes in resins are the bicyclic terpenes, monocyclic terpenes, and a smaller amount of tricyclic sesquiterpenes. Now there are the 5 different methods of extraction. How can we extract out these important resins from the plants? So the first method of extraction is the most familiar method, which is called as the extraction by using solvents. We have to take certain solvent, and the part of the plant which consists of resin should be macerated or percolated in this solvent for a definite period of time, and then the excess of chemical constituent should be dissolved or mixed in this solvent, which is separated out by the concentration method. The second method is extraction by distillation. So distillation method involves the heating method by which the excess the resins are being isolated from the parts of plant or aerial parts of the plant. Extraction by incision method. The incision method is applied on directly on the cambium or bark of the tree. We have the pupil, the person had may have to make the incision large long cuts on the bark or cambium of the plant, and their exudates come out from the plant, which should be collected in a bucket, and then it is separated from the different foreign particles. The fourth method is extraction by heating the plant part containing resins. Fourth method is used by the large higher plants. The plants is directly heat burned by the help of fire, and the resins which should be exuded out, the thick resin which is exudated is collected. The next method is extraction of resin from encrustations. So encrustations is the thick, it is a crust of hard coating upon or within a body as a deposit of lime, sediment, extra. So there is a layer which should be deposited upon the cambiums or the roots of the or the barks of the trees, which should be replaced manually, or and when this crust or this layer is replaced manually, there is certain exudates which come out from the plant, and they should be collected, and these exudates are the resins. So these are the five different methods of extractions which are used to isolate the resins out of trees. Now come to the properties. So let us see the physical properties of resins. As we had seen in the definition, that resins are the hard, transparent or translucent bitter materials. They are invariably heavier than water, and they have the specific gravity ranging from 0.9 to 1.25. Resins are more or less amorphous materials, but rarely crystallizable in nature. Resins, on being heated at a relatively low temperature, when resins are heated at low temperature, they get softens very easily. But ultimately, they melt down, thereby forming either an adhesive or sticky massive fluids. On being heated in the air, that is in the presence of oxygen, resins usually burn redly with a smoky flame by virtue of presence of large number of carbon atoms in their structure. Since there are a number of carbon atoms, it is a long carbon atom containing chain present inside the resins. Therefore, resins can catch fire in the presence of open air by accepting oxygen molecules. On being heated in a closed container, that is in the absence of oxygen, they undergo decomposition. The last physical property is they are practically insoluble in water, but frequently soluble in ethanol, volatile oils, fixed oils, chloral hydrate and non-polar organic solvents. Example, benzene, n-hexane and petroleum ether. So these are the water insoluble particles. Resins are water insoluble exudates, but they are soluble in organic solvents, that is ethanol, volatile oil and extra. Chemical properties. Resin in general are enriched with carbon, deprived of nitrogen and contain little oxygen in their respective molecules. Consequently, the resins are broadly divided into resin alcohols, resin acids, resin esters, glycosidal resins and resins, that is inert neutral compound. Resins are nothing but oxidative product of terpenes. They may also be regarded as the end product of destructive metabolism. The acid resins, when treated with alkaline solution, they yield soaps or resin soaps. Classification. Resins are classified into different types. The first type is acid resin. Example, colophony. It consists of abietic acid. Sandarach consists of the chemical constituent sandarachic acid, shellac, aluratic acid, myrrh, comiphoric acid. The second classification is ester resins, which consist of ester functional group. Example is benzoin, the drug name is benzoin and the chemical constituent is benzyl benzoate. Storex, chemical constituent is cinnamyl cinnamate. Third classification, the alcohols which consist of resins, balsam of Peru, Peru resinotenol, guaiacum resin. Resins. Example, dragon's blood, draco resin, gutta percha, fluvel. Glycosyrins, the next classification. Fifth classification is glycoresins. Example, Zalap resin from Zalap, that is Ipomia, Purga, Hynel, family, Conru, Levulacea. Podophylloresin from the dried roots and rhizomes of Podophyllum hexandrum. The sixth category of resins is oleogum resins. The oleogum resins are the naturally occurring mixtures of resin, gum, volatile oil, asafoetida, and turmeric. Now, there are the few identification tests to identify the different type of resins. So, first is the physical test, such as solubility. We have to determine the solubility, that they are insoluble in water and soluble in certain organic solvents. Test, order, and examination of powder under the microscope. Powder microscopy should be done for physical identification test. The second is, we have to perform the chemical test for identification of resins. We have to perform acid value test, saponification value test, and iodine value test. Then last is specific chemical test for specific type of resins. For specific constituents such as cinnamic acid, benzoic acid, in benzoin, tolua balsam, and perua balsam, we have to perform certain specific identification test. So these are the specific identification tests. The first type of the test which should be performed for the resins is hydrochloride test. In this, reagent used is hydrochloride, and the result we can get, if we get the pink color, formation of pink color, it means there is the presence of resin. Compound is the positive if it shows pink color. The second is ferric chloride test. Ferric chloride is the reagent we use, and the green-blue color indicates the presence of resins in the sample. The third type of the test is combined umbelliferon test. In this is done for the umbelliferon family of trees which consist of resins. The specific test of this specific test is done for the drug asafoetida. Here we can use different chemical substances. Here we can use different chemicals. For example, hydrochloric with concentrated ammonium hydroxide, and the sample is asafoetida, gives blue fluorescence. It means umbelliferon is present. Asafoetida, if treated with nitric acid, gives green color. Asafoetida, if treated with sulfuric acid, gives red color. And if it is washed with water, it gives violet color. All these indications shows the presence of umbelliferon. The last identification test is copper acetate test. Here, the copper acetate test consists of petroleum ether. The sample is taken and mixed with petroleum ether. Emerald green color indicates that the resin sample consists of specific abiotic acid. Uses, it reflects light. This decreases the heat on the flower, thereby protecting them. So the resins, they are the secondary metabolites. And what is the use of the resins in plant? They reflect certain type of light, due to which the flowers decrease the heat on the flowers. The flowers do not able to accept sunlight very much, because these resins reflect the sunlight which are coming from the sun, and thereby protecting the flowers. They are used in the preparation of emulsions. Solid resins are available as adhesives. They are used externally as mild antiseptic agents in the form of ointment and plasters. Resins are local irritant and hence act as the local cathartics, example Zalepa and Ipomia. As an anti-cancer, the drug used is Podophyllum. In bronchial asthma, cannabis is used. They are used externally as mild antiseptic in the form of tinctures. Benzoin is used as the form of tinctures. Turpentine and colophony drugs are used in the form of ointment and plasters. Thank you for your attention. Thanks a lot.